Hey guys, what's up? It's Wolf, your one and only, and today we're going to be playing some more The Alchemist Code. And today, we're actually going to go into something I have not really been doing. We're going to be doing Sahar's Dazzling Black Vein. This one was requested by Kai. I already did this just because it kind of forced me to, basically, just because we had the whole, what was it? Because we had a challenge mission. Yeah, that's what it was. We had a challenge mission we had to do, so yeah, I was kind of forced to do the first one, but I didn't go through the story. So that's kind of what I'm going to go back and do right now. Then we'll catch up with the rest of the story, and then I'll repeat stage one. Then we'll just go through it all. Yeah, the Chronicles. Oh, there was two of them? Wait, hold on, which one's the first one? So it is the ending? Okay. Or are they the same? I guess they're basically the same. But we're gonna be doing normal with this video anyway, so yeah. With that said, let's get into it. Alright, so now that we caught up on episode one. So I gotta kill both of them in one go. Alright then, wait, hold up. Because I know we have some missions that'll basically tell me, hey dude, you gotta do this. Let's see, what were they? Yeah, you gotta complete them all at once. This is gonna be tedious as hell and annoying. But at least you get a set team, I guess. Wait, no items? Well, shit. Fine, why not? Mission one. Yo, whoa. Alright, there we go. Pretty sure we can do this pretty well. Or not. God damn it, woman. Why? Why does your counter have to be so strong? Screw it. I'll go back and do it later. Get out of here. I'm honestly not too worried about this. But yeah, that's mission one. Let's get you on. Alright. Episode two. Alright. Clear after collecting two or more jewels. Three kills, one blow. Alright. Episode two. Let's go. These are wolves, just saying. Not goblins. Okay, what she has. Okay, that'd be terrible. Cues, let's see. Never used this character, but we'll figure something out. We're gonna go here. I thought they would start moving on that turn. Oh, well, he does. Apparently, he's the only one who gets to move. Screw everybody else, right? New jewels from you. Interesting reaction skill. I need to kill them first above everybody. Noted. Damn, dude, just calm down with your effects over there. Like, it's literally just effect after effect. Jeez. Actually, I might just... Oh, I was gonna let her die, but... That wouldn't be the best idea. Nope, still can't do nothing. I'll figure out something. Alright, so the lizard dudes we gotta kill first. No, hell no, I'm not doing that. We can start over from scratch. Alright, so take this out. We're gonna have to counter this with this. You need this. It's crucial. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. You need it. And I don't even buy these things, to be honest. I just let them sit there in the shop. Well, then again, they don't really pop up in the shop now that I think about it. They don't. They just... Yeah, they actually don't show up often. This item is pretty damn rare from what I know. And I really liking this character's stuff. Like, she's like meh. I'm actually really happy I did not summon for her. She's definitely good against fire units, but eh. Zahara is also useless right now. I would literally have to go to him. Okay, there we go. So that summons another character once I collect all those. Let's see. Oh, well, there's nothing I can do about that. Let's do this instead. To be honest, I thought you were gonna sleep. Oh wow, you changed targets. That's weird. Perfect. Stay right there. I was gonna say, I'll take Venom over freaking Paralyzed. Don't you dare do it. Damn, dude. You guys are really ganging up on there. There it comes. There is the daze. I was waiting for that. To be honest, right now it's more important to heal. I like the counterattack though. I was about to say, I swear, if you put us to sleep, I'm fighting you. There it is. Everybody has to stay alive, basically. If anybody dies, it's pretty much over. There you go. Have a small potion. I'm gonna sit right here. Oh, actually, hold up. There we go. Interesting to know that they have hidden mechanics inside of these stages. Alright, episode 2, done. Yeah, I know about the whole Zara thing. I'll do it later. Like I said, I'm not too worried about it right now since we're just basically doing it for a story at this point, so. Alright. Next stage. The auto battle, I could easily do that. You have to have max damage taken. Damn, dude, some of these are really tedious. Okay, so I'm using both of them as a Zahar. Noted. Noted, noted, noted. So I'm guessing you're a assassin? Okay. No potions, huh? Well, no items. I could try that. Alright. Let's get into mission 3. Alright, so what's gonna be going on here? How far do you move? Alright, so all up in this area. So I would want to stop over here. Dude, I hate not starting with jewels. Okay, let's see. That's what I need. Okay, so the first strike needs to be jewels. Not really too worried about the damage thing right now. Like I said, we gotta test out pretty much all of our options here before we actually start doing a mission seriously. Now I need to take more jewels. How much would that be for one attack? Probably like 34 or so? That would be enough. Okay, so yeah, one attack would give me charm. Charm and paralyze would be our main things to use. And plus, he can run up here pretty easily. Question is... so I could just run through the rocks and run straight up here and get the archers. Okay, noted. Okay, so that's one thing we've learned. So basically just like thief. I think these missions count on easy. Guess it was this. Oh, max of 5. Don't really care. Like I said, we're gonna explore first. See what I need to do this. See what I need to do first, and then I'll go back and do it myself. Alright, so let's see. So don't pick up any of those. Seems like they might come to us instead. Yep, there they are. It's a good thing we didn't move, actually. Let's see. That's one thing I should have brought is Angel. I won't even lie, I saw that one coming from like a mile away. Alright, so now they're moving up. Let's see. Your friend has no jewels, but you do, and I don't like it. I knew that was gonna happen. That's annoying. So basically all your stuff is useless. It's basically all AoE. That's annoying. But you get your turn before that starts. So, I'm going to do this. I actually can't do anything about them. Fuck. How far can you reach, actually? Because I'm pretty sure you can reach pretty damn far. Oh yeah, you definitely have her. I figured as much. God damn it. Everything has to be up close with you. Now we're gonna use this. I'm pretty sure I probably passed 5 by now. Yeah, I definitely probably passed like 5 skills. It'd be alright. Holy shit! Yeah, that guy has to die. Jeez, dude. But yeah, it's definitely possible to do without skills. Let's see. Nope, not that. This. I'm not going over there just because he'll force me to collect that. Wow. This bastard's literally targeting him. I figured as much. Are you kidding me? I still can't reach him? Jesus, game. Jeez. There we go. Alright. Episode 4 done. Yep, I did surpass it. I was passively playing, dude. I'll remember next time. I don't know. I think she's suspicious of him or something. With that silence. You mostly can't tell the character's, like, you know, facial expression just because they only put out a few portraits. You don't know if they're worried or anything when it comes to, like, you know, just the dots. I always saw it was just like a smile, and that was it. No healing, no I'll try. No promises, though. Oh, it's just you? Goddamn, dude. I mean, that's gonna be difficult considering you just basically kill yourself, so. that's gonna be a pain in the ass. To be honest, all I'm worried about is getting to the extra dungeon at this point. That's pretty much it. The rest of the stuff I can do at any time. So I'm not too much in a rush. You guys can pretty much understand that. It's not really much of a rush because these are permanent missions. You know, you don't have to do them all in one go. Oh, so duel! Wait, excuse me? What was that? Nani the fuck? Damn it! Why do you have to be so far away, ya douche? Say no more. I shall lay my life on the line. Just imagine if that would have worked. That would have sucked for him. I have the high ground now, boy. Oh shit, no. Okay. Wow. Okay. Wait a minute. Hold on. So, Zahar, you're telling me that you get outspeeded by knights. Dude, you got outsped by a knight, dude. That sucks. No, I will not end it like that. Well, it's almost the 2-hour mark, but the disrespect, Vettel. The disrespect, sir. I gotta say, dude, you got outsped by a knight? Someone that should be slower than you? For shame, sir. For shame. Oh, well. Outsped by a knight? I'll take that one, you know. I don't really care about the rest of it, but you know, that's outsped by a...
What?
Alright. We made it to episode 5. We'll do the rest of the episodes later. So, yeah.
I'm spent by a night.
Dude, you're a Kantar capillary. You're... Know what? Not even gonna say anything else. I'm gonna end it there. Hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you guys for part 2 another day. Until then, peace out. Oh yeah, this is where Kanan's story came in for like the Sacred Stone. Oh, okay. A lot of paladins are still causing chaos. But this is, then again, this is his past, right? So, yeah. Her stance and her portrait just does not fit anything else. If I remember correctly, this guy is one of Edward's relatives, maybe? Not Edward's, Edgar's relatives. Since they both have the last same, well, they both have the last name, same last name, words. I mean, it's hard. That's the last thing he would want is money. Despair? Oh. Salvation by darkness. Okay. Oh yeah, Vettel and Zahar, their whole little rivalry thing. Everybody has their own justice, to be honest, at this point. Everybody in this freaking series. Okay. So that's where episode one's. Oh, nope. Episode one is still going. Oh, this is after the battle. All the members seem quite weird in their own way, to be honest. Just like first impression wise. I don't think they care, to be honest, dude. Your title means nothing at this point. Oh, damn. He doesn't care. He's over here just fighting Vettel. To be honest, Zahar and her are probably relatives, or either she just scares the shit out of him. One of the two. Is she one of those yandere's? Or is she the ones that pretend like she's not worried but actually cares? We'll figure out later in the series. So that's a real question. What happened to the rest of his squad then? They probably died if Zahar was alone with Spica. Well, then again, Spica was up inside of the volcano when first fighting Cannon. No, I think she traveled to the volcano. She was somewhere else. I don't know. Bye. You know what? Fuck it. Basically snitched. So is this what led up to the Sacred Stone? Is that where we're getting at here? Oh, so they are relatives. Okay. So basically, she scares the shit out of them. They got it right the first time. What the hell? Excuse me? Can I get a skin of Zahar in that outfit? All right. No, that explains why he's so obsessed with darkness. He grew up in darkness. Oh, so is that like blood sisters? Yeah, blood sister. Blood relative? Is it he a half elf too? No, so he was like an elf. That explains a lot of the pointy ears. I thought he was just like some kind of weird race among the Alchemist Code. Totally changed your like standing point towards a lot of the characters. Because you kind of think that he is mostly human and stuff, but then you think about the pointed ears. So yeah, basically half elf. Or an high elf. Oh, well then. You know, now that I think about it, I never really looked and noticed her hands. Her hand was like this. I never noticed that at all. I always thought her hands were just to her side. He's still curious about outside. I have a lot of questions, but I'm gonna save them until the end. Damn, it doesn't even seem like a brother and sister relationship. It just seems like flirting at this point. But then again, yeah. Protecting family. You could just either see it both ways, to be honest. I feel like she's planning something. I don't, like, fully trust her. Oh, somebody's gonna lose their fingers. So it's just literally a village of high elves. Huh. Okay, I see. Never mind. I get it. First, I thought it was just like him living among humans and stuff. So he just stayed in the house or something. And just a lot of weird stuff, but it's clearing up a few things that I had in mind. His first taste of alchemy.
Nee. so?
I mean, yeah, nothing else better to do, you know? Might as well. So she's more closer to Zahar than Tsubika was, for sure. So is it like a one-sided love with Tsubika then? That's the thing I'm curious about. Oh, most elves, all they know is the forest, to be honest. Most of them. Not really. Especially somebody prison me and shit, dude. Yeah, so I guess around this time he'll run into Vettel sooner or later. Cause didn't he join the Holy Knights at first? Hold on. I'm pretty sure he joined the Holy Knights. If I remember correctly from the sacred stone. Then what happened to her? Those are not goblins. I just want that to be known. I guess wolves are goblins now. And then they're going to get in trouble just for using alchemy to save a village. Yeah, normal cliche. Sounds about right. Oh, so they've met the cleric before. So this is where he joins the Holy Knights. Okay. Especially if they're recruiting. Yeah, and also cause mass destruction for recommendation too. You can go ahead and put that on the list as well. But then again, you can't see the future, so yeah. Oh, damn. So the cleric is just involved in everything. So he pretty much formed Zahara's group out of basically his own stupidity. So because you send a recommendation to Zahar, well, for Zahar, apparently he owes you everything. I mean, nobody asks you to write the recommendation, you know? Just saying. Ah, well, that's pretty much a lie. Good job. Damn, you swore in a house you were born in? Fucking savage. This man did not change clothes, he just changed the color. He just literally... Okay. Oh, you fell in love? What the hell, man? No, I'm just kidding. To be honest, he probably knows by now that you're trying to kill him. Well, they probably know that he's an assassin. He's probably specialized in killing. That's probably why they gave him the mission. So not only did we get to learn more about Zahar, but we're actually learning more about his crew, if anything. So it's basically a story all in one.
Huh? Oh.
Oh, well then. He's a better assassin than you. That man's completely stealth if you didn't notice. See, I was right. He definitely knew. Yeah, I figure Lionheart. So isn't that Edgar's last name too? What happened to what's her face? That's the thing that's been bothering me this whole time. Like, while he was in the Paladins, I don't think she ever showed up again. All right, to be honest, Zahar was kinda in a weird way a hero or good guy, but he mostly went about it in the wrong type of way. The reason I say he's more of a good guy is just because the Holy Knights were doing like some sketchy shit and some unhonorable crap. And they basically did, you know, trick their whole knights into doing what they say. Why, Zahara kind of saw through it. But he still went about it the wrong way. That's the reason why he's mostly still a villain in a way. Same thing with Diaz. But Diaz was a dumbass. That's all we can say. It's Waggy. What are you doing here, dude? Oh yeah, never mind, Paladins.
Mm-hmm.
Heh. Dude, you guys fucking suck. The only time you guys are good when you're hitting across the map on that one freaking mission. I think it was the freaking Full Metal Alchemist event. That's the only time you guys are ever good. Damn. Oh, it's her. Okay. That explains. That explains what happens to her. Ah, okay. So that's where she's been this whole time. Wait, we're gonna explain how his eyes just randomly turned, but okay. Huh. I'm kind of liking Zahar's story so far. Well, him and his crew's story. It's still funny that all the characters are still playing out their sins of their main country. Cause Raph and Zahar go together pretty much really good. I haven't really seen a single character that has acted differently from their hometown, to be honest. Or not their hometown, their own country. I mean, to be honest, they got along at the start of the story, so I think they kind of meet like a sort of standard to each other. They start getting along a little bit better. Got his ass. All right, stormtroopers, calm down.
Thanks.
Damn. Dude, I've been wanting to throw hands with the corpse through every last time they've popped up since, well, pretty much through the whole Sacred Stone. Let me throw hands at this point. They're a whole bunch of douches. Damn. So he says speaker. Yeah, we read that part. Also, we get to see Spica's point of view.
So.
No.
I mean, she is the strategist at all, after all, so yeah, she got this. Don't worry about it, dude. See, they're growing more used to each other than, like, sketchy, but I'm pretty sure they're still on the toes when it comes to each other, though. You know, you wouldn't take Speaker for being more of like, she seems like a spy, but then again, you know, you never know. Spies could have went out and get her detail. So it is a one-sided love. Feels bad, Speaker. Feels bad. But then again, she could just look up to him, if anything. Okay, I figured they were like sisters or something. Oh no, she definitely loves him. I was right. One sided love. No, oh, that's when you first met Vettel, I guess. Yeah, I figured. You say that, but then, you know, Flash to the Future. But then again, it was mostly canon who did it, so. Damn. Your spider senses, calm down.
Shorty.
I thought she was just gonna jump in the middle of the battle. About to say that's the wrong thing to do, is jump in the middle of a battle with Zahar. Swear it's gonna get better real soon. Don't let anyone tell you what you should do. I got a clear view. We're gonna make it soon. Just keep pushing through. You're what you got to lose. You're what you got to lose. You're what you got to lose. Just keep pushing through. 'Cause what you got to lose.